Hey everybody, welcome to Cars Jubilee. My name is Victor and today you join me in the Genesis Electrified G80. And today I'm going to tell you my 7 favorite features about this car, as well as 3 really interesting features about this car. So let's get to it. The first feature we're going to start with is what's called this forged wood garnish. Now, according to Genesis, this is real wood. Apparently, it's recycled pieces of wood from the furniture manufacturing process, and it's supposed to reflect the sustainable luxury of the Genesis brand. Now, I have read somewhere that they're saying it's recycled birch or discarded birch. Now, I'm not sure if that's true, but what I am sure about is that this thing looks amazing, and you can get it in different colors depending on what interior color you choose. Here in the US, there's also a black spec and there's also a brown spec. And as you can see from the photos pulled from the Genesis website, it looks pretty different. Now, I haven't seen these other ones in real life, but at least the one that I'm in right now already looks amazing. Maybe the next time I pop by the dealership, I'll ask to take a look and get some extra photos for you guys. But hey, this wood looks really, really unique. Truly just an eye-popping feature as soon as I got in this car. The next feature that I really, really like about this car is actually the interior two-tone color. Genesis calls this the Lagoon Green and the Glacier White interior. Now, maybe you're thinking it looks a little familiar. Well, that's because it really matches my Ioniq 5 with the dark green interior and the gray two-tone seats. Now, this green is not quite green, it's kind of bluish. But it's also not quite blue like my GV60's Torrent Navy Blue. It's somewhere right in between, where depending on the light that hits it, you get hints of green, and other times you get hints of blue. But all I can say is it just makes this interior pop. There's a lot more color, and I love it. For the next feature, we have to move out front, and that's because it's actually the front grille. I mean, I love how they filled it in, and it's become a really cool design piece or design element instead of just an afterthought. I think it looks amazing. And the next feature happens to be the hidden charge port, which is right here. Do you see it? I would say without this little marker here, I probably wouldn't know it's here. It really does blend in, and I think it'll be surprising a lot of people when you pull up to a charger and suddenly reveal your secret charge port door. The next feature would be the wheels. Now, Genesis has been creating just ridiculously good wheel designs. Here's some examples that I saw in person at Genesis House. Now, I'm not really sure how efficient these are from an aero perspective, but man, they look stunning. And the next feature that I really, really enjoy is actually the massaging seats. And I have it in my GV60, but this one just feels stronger and more intense. I'm not really sure how they achieved that, but hey, it works really well in here. Now on to the last feature, and that would be the driver's display. I saved this for last because this might be my favorite feature. Nowadays, with most screens going digital, you're probably not going to call any of them beautiful because it's all digital. Except you might in this G80. In comfort mode, these gauges just look so elegant. I feel like they belong in a Rolls-Royce or a Bentley. As in, these are the kinds of analog gauges I would expect in those kinds of cars. But here it is on a digital display in a Genesis. So I think I'm going to call this maybe Rolls-Royce mode. Now, if you flip it to Eco, all of a sudden it seems so futuristic and it reminds me of the movie Tron. So I'm going to call it Tron mode. And then this last one is Sport mode. And you have these really cool red lightsabers. I'm probably going to call it Lightspeed mode in honor of Star Wars. Now, on top of all this, the driver's display has a 3D view mode. And unfortunately, it doesn't really show well in pictures or videos, but if you ever get a chance to see it in person, It's crazy. There is depth to everything. So what they're doing is essentially pushing the gauges back behind everything. So when you look at it, it feels like there's two levels to the gauges, or in fact, there's only one. It's just like watching a 3D movie. You feel like there's depth when there's really not. For me, this is the craziest driver's display I have ever seen in my life. I think it's amazing. Okay, now we move on to the three interesting features about this G80. Number one is the fact there's no battery percentage in your driver's display. There is a battery meter. This gauge or meter looks pretty reminiscent of gas-powered cars. It's just kind of vague, right? There's no exact percentage. And nowadays with EVs, we kind of expect to see an exact percentage somewhere at all times. And that's actually not the case here with this Electrified G80. You can find the battery percentage in the infotainment screen if you go to the EV menu. However, outside of that, you're not going to find an exact percentage. You're just going to look at this gauge that's kind of vague. And honestly, to an extent, I've kind of enjoyed that. It's a lot less range anxiety when you don't know the exact battery percentage because you're not constantly just staring at it. Now, when I'm running low on charge, it's kind of inconvenient to have to go through an extra step to see my battery percentage. I think that was a really, really interesting choice by Genesis. Interesting feature number two is the fact that the driver's display does not have a numerical speedometer. Now, in this day and age, pretty much every car has a numerical speedometer, meaning you'll see your miles per hour in just a number form. But this G80 has it in analog form on a digital display. And that's really interesting because my past four or five cars have all had a numerical speedometer, so that with just a quick glance down, I could see the exact speed that I was going. And all of a sudden, switching back to something that looks like analog, I looked down and I realized I have no idea how fast I'm going. There is just a different level of concentration needed to read an analog style speedometer. Now, there is a heads-up display, and that does kind of remove this problem, but again, it's just really interesting to see a gauge cluster without a digital or numerical speedometer in this day and age. Now, I mentioned before, I think this driver display looks gorgeous the way they designed it, and I think it's a worthwhile trade-off to get this type of design and not have that ease of use, but just a really interesting design choice, again, by Genesis. And the last interesting feature, or in this case, lack of feature, is the fact that there's no sunroof here. Now, the gas-powered G80 does. They have a large panoramic roof that lets in just a ton of light. But this G80, this electrified version, does not. There is no option for it. Does it really affect the interior? I don't think so, at least not in this color, because so much light comes in, these seats are so bright. But I do think it was just an interesting choice not to have it as an option. Anyways, that's it for my favorite features as well as some interesting features about this Electrified G80. I do plan, hopefully, to do some more content with it while I have it. So if you have any questions about it, feel free to shoot me a comment in the comment section below. As always, if you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next one.